time, don't fight to love. You will miss sunrise if you close your eyes. That will break my heart.
This song was written in a place north of Amsterdam called Alkmaar. I have a friend there, her name's Dory, and I was introduced to her a couple of years ago, and we wrote a song together, and we stayed in touch, and we have written more songs together. But she had this place in Alkmaar. She was an official squatter, apparently in the Netherlands. They would rather have people officially squatting in buildings than letting them become derelict. So you can apply to live in a house. And she did that. She had like a church almost, or a mosque or something. She had this giant gym with a sail in it, a sail for a boat. That was dividing this room into a studio and a living space. It was quite strange. Anyway, I was on tour with Kinley. We were in, we're on our last leg of that little journey in the Netherlands. It was February, and we were walking into Amsterdam for dinner. Parked our car, and we were walking into Amsterdam. And it started to snow in this very magical way. It was like a snow globe, basically. And as far as I know, it doesn't really snow that much in Amsterdam. So it was kind of this magical moment that I felt privy to, and maybe it's because we're Canadian, maybe that's why it snowed, I don't know. But it was a magical moment, and we went back to Alkmaar. We drove through the snow back to Alkmaar. Kinley passed out, and I sat and I wrote this tune called Snowing in Amsterdam. Just give me 2 seconds, I'm gonna get this guitar. This is an open C tuning. Very, very low on the guitar. Thank you very much, Sarah. He's probably got some blood in him. Useless creature.
I'm a murderer.
It was kind of strange sitting in a stranger's house, which is not really a stranger, but that we were there. And this is the first song I've written in a while.
Thank you.
I'm sitting here drinking, staring at the wall. Baby, I'm thinking of you. Home in the heart of the Charlotte town winter, it's snowing in Amsterdam.
I'm gonna play one more song in this tuning, and this is a song I've never even performed ever before. But it was written in Alkmaar with Jori.
What?
On that same trip.
I don't know the song, but I'm faking it like a pro.
It'll be great.
Check it.
It's called Make It Right. That's the thing about this show, when we sat down and started thinking about it, what should we do, what should we play? And it became clear to us that we could do whatever we wanted. So here we are.
When you're in front of this many people and you're about to sing a song that you don't know, you feel really naked. You're supposed to picture the audience naked, but when you're doing that, you're actually feeling very naked yourself. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go back to picturing you all naked. It's a lovely sight, by the way. So one of my favorite songwriters is Sean Colvin. I don't know if any of you are familiar with her music. She's really, really cool, and I've been a huge fan since I was a teenager. And I was on this tour, a very exciting experience for me as a young woman. I got to tour with Lilith Fair. And I don't know if you remember that. That was it was a long time ago now. But I got to sing with all these great, great female singers, and I met Sean Colvin. And we were sitting beside each other at a press conference, and I was freaking out inside. I'm like, oh my God, I'm about to meet Sean Colvin. Anyway, problem was, you should never meet the people that you love the most. She was super, super pregnant, and she was sitting directly in a sunbeam, so she was like sweating and miserable and nauseous. And I'm like, hi Sean, I just want you to know I'm a huge fan. And she just kind of looked at me and she was like, oh, do you think I can change seats? And I took it personally in that moment because I didn't realize that she was experiencing this. And then I was like, oh, right, okay, yes, of course, not about me. Yes, let's find you a different seat where you can not be hot and sweaty and pregnant. I mean, she'll still be pregnant, but maybe just not hot and sweaty. And, but that was it. Like, those were the only words that I got from her. And I remember being so sad after, and then I saw her on Oprah, and she was just talking about how tremendously challenging her pregnancy was, and how she had, like, it was like the hardest time in her life. And I was like, I met one of my favorite songwriters during the hardest time in her life, and you know what? That's cool, you know. But I just made a point of like never touring while I was pregnant. So this next song is one of Sean's, and it's one of my faves, and I made Dennis learn it so that I can sing.
Just 1 second.
Okay.
It's so human.
Stand up.
It's so human today that this guitar coming down and then coming back up.
It feels like we're getting.
It's like
the
Sean Colvin sitting in a sunbeam while she's pregnant. That's what my guitar feels like.
That's how your guitar feels like. Yeah, it's quite warm up here. I like it though.
I am ready. I have never played this song before. This is the portion of the set where we get naked. Let me sing the song for me for a second, Tara. Sing a little bit of it.
On the wind and that sea. Ha ha. You
set the